Are you ready to enjoy music again? Stay right there for Neon Music Country Legacy with Randy Moore.
Thank you very much, Bert. Welcome to Neon Music Country Legacy. My name is Randy C. Moore, and I'm your host. Now it's time to get the music started.
A million stars were in the sky, 4 a.m. on the 5th of July. We headed out to Toledo Bend, me and Daddy going fishing again. He said we'll be there in an hour or so. Charlie Rich was on the radio. I said, I hope that we get lucky today. He nodded his head and I heard him say, if the good Lord's willing and the mercury runs, we'll be on the water before the sun. With rods, reels, and spinner baits, we'll cast our troubles out into the lake. Cause life is a whole lot better when the fishing's fine. And there's a little bit of heaven at the end of that line. Now we pulled in to Choctaw Camp, eased that bass boat down the rack. I held the rope while it parked the truck. I caught myself waking up. He got us out to our honey hole. How it finds it, I never know. I said, all these trees look alike. He said, son, you can trust an old Indian guide. When the good Lord's willing and the mercury runs, we'll be on the water before the sun. With rods, reels, and spinner baits, we'll cast our troubles out into the lake. This life is a whole lot better when the fishing's fine. And there's a little bit of heaven at the end of that line. Now when I think about my daddy, I think about fishing. And I think about fishing every day. When I die and leave this place, I want to see my daddy's face, saying, get the rods and reels, son, we're heading to the lake. A million stars were in the sky, 4 a.m. on the 5th of July. We headed out to Toledo Bend, me and Daddy going fishing. Again. La 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 la. Come on, let's go fishing. La 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 la. Grab the rods and reels, how does it feel? Son, don't you wanna go fishing? Daddy, I wanna go fishing.
Hi folks, glad you're here with us on Neon Music Country Legacy. My name is Randy C. Moore and I am your host. Today's a great show because in our Neon Spotlight, we have the one and only Walt Aldridge. Great songwriter, great songs. I know you're going to enjoy this show. So hang around, here comes some more music right now.
I remember my co-writer on this song, Bruce Miller, coming in. He had the lyrical idea for it. Just sitting there noodling around trying to come up with that little guitar riff on the beginning. Several of my songs, I came up with a guitar lick that sort of marked the song so that when you heard it, you instantly knew what the song was. And you know, the lyrics were not that hard for us to come up with, but it just took me forever to try to come up with a guitar part to get it kicked off. So here's Reba McEntire and The Fear of Being Alone.
You told me your story and I thought about mine. lost everything. It all started having a familiar ring. So I asked you to take me someplace quiet. We wound up at the river for the rest of the night. Somewhere around the break of day, I could hear it coming from a mile away. So don't say that word, not the one. We both heard too much. You may think you do, but you don't. It's just the fear of being alone.
Better Off Blue came from a conversation I was having with my co-writer, Susan Longacre. We were talking about somebody that she knew that was in a struggle in a relationship, just not knowing what to do. And I remember saying, well, you know, be better off being blue than having to deal with that. Susan immediately said, man, yeah, let's write a song about that. So many times songs come from places like that, you know, just conversations you have, observations about other people. And Pam Tillis did a terrific version of Better Off Blue that wound up being a good, pretty good chart record for her. Wasn't it you who said it was a
Okay, folks, as I promised you earlier, our neon spotlight is shining on the great Walt Aldridge. I'm going to tell you a little bit about Walt. He grew up in Florence, Alabama, and he began making his own music by the way of a guitar that he got for Christmas. Now, he was drawn to the singer-songwriter type of artists like James Taylor and Neil Young, as well as John Prine and Randy Newman. Now, he eventually made his way to Muscle Shoals Fame Studio, which wasn't too far from his hometown, and he pretty much learned the studio recording business from a legendary producer, Rick Hall. As Walt will tell you, when he got hired, he was just a gopher. You know, go for cigarettes, go for hamburgers, go for whatever was needed. But it was all part of some well-needed experience in the music business. Now, not a lot of people know this, but the first song that Walt Aldridge ever had recorded was sold to a popular group called the Hager Brothers, who at the time were regulars on the show Hee Haw. And it's not too long after that that Walt just kept pursuing his songwriting, and he hit platinum pay dirt with a Ronnie Millsap number one single, There Ain't No Getting Over Me. What a great song. As Walt will tell you, he was able to follow up with more success in the songwriting business, but it wasn't easy. With chart-topping songs by Travis Tritt, Conway Twitty, Shenandoah, Earl Thomas Conley, and Heartland, Walt was on a roll and he was on the move. At some point in time, he actually formed his own act because he got signed to a label deal. He called the act the Shooters, and that was a really cool band, by the way. I always liked listening to their records. His great career has earned them the distinguished honor of a Music Achiever by the Alabama Music Hall of Fame, which is always a precursor to a future induction, and he's been awarded a star on the Alabama Music Hall of Fame Walk of Fame. Aldridge also holds multiple degrees from the University of Alabama, and today we are honored to have him standing at the neon spotlight with us. Now here's Walt with some personal insight on some of his great, great songs.
I Loved It First came from a conversation I was having with a co-writer, Elliot Park, and he and I were talking about the fact that we both have two daughters and how hard it was going to be someday to have to give those girls away at a wedding. I've gotten to experience what that's really like, but at the time it was only guessing, and he had started the song. I had the idea to move it in a little different direction. You were talking about an ex-girlfriend, ex-lover, until you got to the chorus and then dropped the bomb on everybody. When we finished it, I thought it was a hit. Finally, I was finally right, and it was recorded by Heartland. I Loved Her First.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment and each other's face. So much in love, you're alone in this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one, she told me so. And she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday. But it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. How could that beautiful woman with you be the same freckle faced kid that I knew, the one that I read all those fairy tales to, and tucked into bed all those nights? And I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time. I loved her first, I held her first,
that a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. Someday you might know what I'm going through, when a miracle smiles over you. I loved her first.
You're listening to
The Legacy,
Neon Music Country Legacy.
Well, Leave Him Out of This was another one of those songs that I really worked hard at trying to get a guitar intro on. So that guitar thing that actually my buddy Mac McAnally played that on the record, that sort of marked the song. Wrote it with Susan Longacre, and we were talking about how hard that is when people get in a relationship and there's somebody that just, one of the people can't get out of their minds. And it's sort of like there's a ghost in there that makes it really hard for the relationship to be good. Always kind of somebody in between. And this guy is just finally at the end of his rope saying, man, just this one time, leave him out of this. Let's let it just be us. Here's one of my favorite singers and pickers, Steve Warner, doing Leave Him Out of This.
Three of us again. You and me are lying here with your memory of him. You say I've lost my mind, but you say that every time it's more than jealousy. Just as tight as me. And I beg you, just one time, leave him out of this. Don't throw it all away for somebody that you knew. I wish you could. Next to me, we're as close as we can get, someone in between. You say I'm dreaming this, you haven't seen him since he said his last goodbye. Close your eyes. And I beg you, just one time, leave him out of this.
love to me tonight and leave him out of this. Make love to me tonight and leave him out of this.
My friend and co-writer James LeBlanc is from Shreveport, Louisiana, and he was driving up to Muscle Shoals, where I was from and living and working. He came through an area where Bonnie and Clyde had been finally caught and killed. He picked up this little pamphlet at this service station. They had reenactments, shooting of Bonnie and Clyde, and he said, you know, we ought to write a song about Bonnie and Clyde, only, you know, with a different twist. And I said, well, maybe it could be a sort of a modern day version of that. And he began playing that little guitar lick at the beginning that sort of marks the song, and it just took off from there. So here's Travis Tritt with modern day Bonnie and Clyde.
Well, it's a long way to Richmond, rolling off on 95. With a redhead riding shotgun and a pistol by my side. Tearing down that highway like a modern day Bonnie and Clyde. We met at a truck stop, Johnson City, Tennessee. Boy, do you need some company? She had me stopping at a Quick Mart before we made it out of town. Next thing she was running at me, telling me to lay that hammer down. Oh, there's a man right behind me, doing his best to slow me down. Yeah, and it's a long way to Richmond, rolling up on 95. With a redhead riding shotgun and a pistol by my side. Tearing down that highway like a modern day Bonnie and Clyde. And stolen Marlboro Lights. Lord, we never saw him coming till they read us both our rights. Yeah, and it's a long way to Richmond, rolling north on 95, with a sheriff right beside. A disappointing ending for this modern day Bonnie and Clyde. Yeah. Whoa. Whoa.
a co-writer on this song who was visually impaired, John Gerard. He's written a lot of great country songs and unfortunately is no longer with us, but he was blind. And we were riding one day and I was just kind of staring out the window and I said, "Looks like there's a storm coming up, John." I didn't know if he even knew since he couldn't see. And he said, "Well, I can't see the storm, but I can smell the rain." And as soon as he said that, it was kind of like one of those light bulb moments. You know, we both sort of said, "Man, that ought to be a country song." And we began writing this song and got it to Black Hawk, and they took it to the top.
She hasn't done a thing that really has to mean she's going anywhere. Haven't seen it showing in her eyes, but I swear it must be there. I don't know why I feel it so strong, but I feel it just the same. I can't see a single storm cloud in the sky, but I sure can smell the rain. She'd still say I love you if I asked, but she never volunteers. Somehow what she never says means more than all the other words I hear. She should win an Oscar if she's lying when she says that nothing's changed. I can't see a single storm cloud in the sky, but I sure can smell the rain. Every day she's gonna say, and every night I thank the Lord somehow I dodged a bullet one more day. Sometimes there are things a man just knows that he really can't explain. Single storm cloud in the sky, but I sure can smell the rain. I can't see a single storm cloud in the sky, but I sure can smell the rain.
No Getting Over Me was the very first country single I ever even had. I was only 25 years old at the time, and I didn't realize how lucky I was that all the stars had sort of lined up in the first place, having an artist like Millsap, who was a great country singer. But he was also, he had a little blues quality to his voice, and that song lended itself well to that. The timing was right, everything came out, it was perfect, and it went straight to the top, and I thought, man, this is easy, you know, but of course it's not.
Well, you can walk out on me tonight if you
you think that it ain't feeling right, but darling, there ain't no getting over me. Well, you can say that you need to be free, but there ain't no place that I won't be. Sweet darling, there ain't no getting over me. I'll be the bill you forgot to pay. I'll be the dream that keeps you awake. I'll be the song on the radio. I'll be the reason that you tell the boys no. Don't you know? Can tell everyone that we're through, and you might even believe it too. But darling, there ain't no getting over me. Sweet darling, there ain't no getting over me.
Listening to
The Legacy,
Neon Music Country Legacy.
I was and am good friends with the guys in the band Shenandoah. They're from the North Alabama area there where I'm from, and I was friends with both their producers as well. Worked many years with Rick Hall and with Robert Byrne, and Robert and I went away on a writing trip. We were going to try to spend a few days in Florida trying to write some songs. The very first night we were there, we wrote See If I Care, and I was convinced it was a smash. I was so convinced that I don't think we wrote anything else the rest of the time. I just thought, you know what, if we don't write another note, the trip has been worth it. They did a fantastic version of it, and it wound up being a hit for them, See If I Care.
If I'll be around, people
wears off. Will you be smiling and dialing my number to see if I'm still there? Give me a call and see if I care. See if I care.
You're listening to
The Legacy,
Neon Music Country Legacy.
Some things never change, I wrote with my pal Brad Chrysler. When we finished writing that song, I said, man, we got to write something just musically, just creative and for fun here. I have lost touch with that, and let's just sit down and let something. And some things never change. It did. It just goes to show you, sometimes you work really hard trying to get something to happen, and then sometimes it just flows. And that was the case with this song that was a hit for Tim McGraw.
Oh,
I had started a band called The Shooters in the late 80s, and we were on Epic Records, and we were making our own records, and we were having some songs on the radio and out there touring, and I was trying to write songs for us. And when I wrote this song, that's who I had in mind. It just so happened that my publisher heard the song and said, "Man, you know, Conway Twitty's looking for material right now, and I just really think this would be perfect for him. What do you think about playing it to him?" And I said, "Well, man, yeah, if we could get a Conway cut on it, I'd be hard-pressed to turn it down. You know, he's one of the greats." And he recorded it and went to number one, and it went on to record several of my songs, but this was the only real hit out of the batch. I just loved Conway's version and loved Conway. He was just a great artist and a real gentleman to be around. I remember writing Holding Her and Loving You. It came really fast for us. Some songs do, but that song just sort of came together in a hurry. It was recorded by Earl Thomas Conley in a hurry. It just seemed like it was destined to be, because it all along the way, it was everything was working. So many times in the business, it's not that way. You feel like you're fighting and you're scrapping and you're trying to get things to happen the way you want them to. But in the case of that song and the way it was written and recorded and everything, it just came together in a big hurry and wound up being one of my favorite songs I ever wrote.
It's the third hardest thing I'll ever do, leaving here without you. And the second hardest thing I'll ever do is telling her about you. She's been good to me when things were going rough. How can I tell her now? Good ain't good enough. All the hardest thing I've ever had to do is holding her and loving you. If she'd give me one good reason, I'd be gone. But she ain't done one thing wrong. So don't expect me just to walk out of the door. I still love her, but I love you more. She's been good to me when things weren't going right. She made my days long before you made my nights. So the hardest thing I've ever had to do is holding her and loving you. Yeah, the hardest thing I've ever had to do is holding her and loving you. Girl, the hardest thing I've ever had to do is holding her and loving you.
Sometimes songs come from a real place, sometimes they're just made up. You know, like the saying goes, you don't have to be a murderer to write a murder mystery. And I think if songwriters had to live every single thing that they wrote about, they'd probably write pretty boring songs. I was disagreeing with my wife about something or other. I went to the bedroom, shut the door, and just sat down and started communicating the way that I best know how to communicate and always have, and that is just expressing myself through a song. And, you know, I was really honored that Ricky Van Shelton did it, and they did just a terrific job on the song I Am a Simple Man.
I don't know why you want to start with me. As I can see, and I'm worn out from working too hard. Why don't you give me a break? I know that lately things ain't been so good. I'll make it up just like I told you I would. But I'm tired and I wanna sit down to ease the soul back ache. You say you're having trouble figuring me. Such a mystery. Baby, what you get is what you see. I am a simple man.
hard for me to understand. I am a simple man. You say we got some things to talk about, a lot of problems that we need to work out, but we just in the fighting. Why don't you give it a rest? I can say to you, I'm doing everything I know to do, and I can't give you anything more when I'm giving my best. Say you're having trouble figuring me, I don't believe I'm such a mystery. Baby, what you get is what you see. I am a simple man. Hard for me to understand. I am a simple man. I want a place I can lay my head. Soft woman and a warm bed. A little time off before I'm dead. I'm just a simple man. You say you're having trouble figuring me, I don't believe in such a mystery. Baby, what you get is what you see. I am a simple man.
All right, folks, we're glad you joined us here today on Neon Music Country Legacy, and we hope you enjoyed this great show with the great Walt Aldridge. Now, thanks for tuning in to this radio station, and tune in again next week for another installment of Neon Music Country Legacy. I'm your host, Randy C. Moore. If you'd like more info about our show or would like to give us a shout-out, we are on Facebook at Neon Music Country Legacy. You can find more out about your friendly neighborhood host at Randy C. Moore Music. That's Randy, initial C, Moore, M-O-O-R-E, Music, on Facebook, or go to randycmoore.com. Hey, folks, I want to introduce you to this song of mine right now. It's called Leukenbach. And the thing about Leukenbach is it's just a little bitty place in Texas. And there's two kind of people that go to Leukenbach. There's the kind of people that go there and they say, is this it? And then there's other people that go there and say, this is it. Here's a song from my current album, Leukenbach, for all the folks who say, this is it. Here's Leukenbach.
The time clock dead on our feet. Too many nights going to bed, just going to sleep. Ending the days like they begun, never dancing to the beat of the drum. Leaving me begging the questions I'm asking you now. Do you want to go to Leukenbach? Waiting and waiting, feeling no pain. Or go walking up, drive walking. Sunrise over the mountaintop. When you're in love, it doesn't take a lot. Like you was going back to Leukenbach. We've seen tropical beaches full of beautiful people working on tents. But people on top of other people are a traffic jam. Taking those selfies, waiting in line, telling the friends is the lie. I hope they never discover where we're going now. Do you want to go looking back? We're waiting and waiting, feeling no pain. We'll go walking up, drive over roads, man.
Thank you for listening to Neon Music Country Legacy with Randy Moore. I'm Burke Gagnon. Stay well, stay safe, enjoy music again.